She planted her first collection about 60 years ago, and at one time there were 1,000 cultivars. She was internationally known as a daffodil breeder, and the Indiana Daffodil Society has been helping to keep them up, and Mrs. Link had asked them in particular to take some of those cultivars into their gardens toward the end of her life. It's interesting, people who have come here for years. I had a guy come from New York. He was a teenager down the road, and he would come and help her once in a while and could remember her, you know, having him help out here. But I've had people come who said back when the gardens were all full and the daffodils went around the pond, they would come and she'd come over and talk with them and then invite them to their porch for lemonade or iced tea. And so they would just have these conversations about growing daffodils. When I sit out like this, this is my church for the day. You hear the birds. Mm-hmm. And, you know, today you see new growth. The trees are starting to turn, you know, the various shades of green. The red buds growing. You see the pink in the, you know, in the background. And then still not enough leaves on some of the trees that you see the patterns of the branches going up. Mm-hmm. You know, and it's just something rather beautiful. And you look up in the sky, but it's so clear. To me, this is the closest thing to God and nature that you can get, is sitting here. It's such a pleasure to get back.
Thank you. Thank you.